Our last topic when dealing with sales tax is a very rare situation. Multiple sales tax in the same sale. Why would there be more than one sales tax in one sale? The ship-to location could be different for each item on the invoice. There could be federal excise tax or luxury tax on only some of the items on the invoice and state taxes on the other items in the same invoice. The truth is, who knows what other reason there might be? It does happen, but it's very rare. There are two setup steps to be able to do this. First, we have to create a tax item with 0%, and we can give it a name called multiple rates, and we can use any vendor, or we can create a dummy vendor for this new sales tax item. Let's go ahead and do this first step now. From the main menu, click List, Item List. Then in the bottom left, click Item, New. Now, this is a sales tax item, and the name will be Multiple Rates. So that's the name that will show up in the invoice at the moment that we make the invoice, and it will be at the bottom. The description will be Sales Tax for Multiple Rates in One Sale. And of course, the rate we leave as zero, and we could choose one of the other tax agencies or add a new one just called dummy, just to have a vendor associated with this item, and we click OK. Now we're halfway done setting up for what we need to do. Now all we have to do to finish the setup is create a subtotal item called Total Taxable. Again, from the main menu, click List, Item List. Then in the bottom left, click Item, New. The type is subtotal and the name is Total Taxable. And now we're ready and we're all set up and we can now see how it works. So let's try this example. Imagine on March 15th, we sent an invoice to Candy for 3 editing items and 4 business suits, which are clothing items that we have to describe and put the money in. Those items are taxed at the New York State tax rate. And on the same invoice, we sold 4 video items that the computer will remember are $300 each, and 5 wedding gowns, which are also clothing items where we have to put in the money amount and the description. But these items will be taxed at the New Jersey rate, for whatever reason. So let's take a look at how we would do this. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. The date we will put back to March 15th, and the customer is Candy. Now, Candy is normally New Jersey tax, but because this has multiple tax rates, here at the bottom, we will change this to multiple rates, 0%. Click OK for the warning. The reason we have to make it 0% down here is because we're actually going to physically put the tax item ourselves in the body of the invoice. That's the only way to accomplish this, and we don't want to count the tax twice. You'll see. So the first item is editing, and it's 3, and the computer knows that's 140 per item. And then the other item is 4 business suits, $600 each, which is a clothing item. So the next line we choose clothing item, 4, and we will describe it as business, suits, and of course, they are $600 each. just click OK for the price level warning. Now, we're going to use many lines in this invoice. So what I suggest is, in addition to collapsing the panel on the side, just for this video, you should also collapse the ribbon so that you can see more lines while you do this, because this method requires seeing a lot of lines. So now that we have the two items that are taxable for New York, here's what we need to do. In the next line, choose the subtotal item called taxable, total taxable. And that's a subtotal. And then it gives a number that's grayed out because a subtotal item adds what's above it. Now, directly under the taxable total for New York, you physically choose the New York State sales tax item, which is on your items list. The tax item will calculate the tax on whatever is on the line above it. And the line above it is a subtotal of only the items that are taxable for New York. So this is the only time that you'll actually put the tax item in the body of the invoice by placing it yourself. Notice the multiple rate item that you chose down here is zero. That's because you don't want to double count. You want the New York State to show it up here, and you don't want it to count this as an item and charge you tax on it. So now we have the other two items according to the instruction, four items of video, which the computer remembers is $300 each. And of course, the last item is five wedding gowns, $700 each. So the quantity is five. The item is clothing. We describe it as wedding gowns. And it's, I believe, $700 each. Very expensive wedding gowns. Now, under the items that are taxable for New Jersey, first we choose the total taxable as the subtitle item. Now we're going to have to scroll down no matter what. Then under the total taxable subtotal for the items that are taxed for New Jersey, under the subtotal, we put the New Jersey sales tax item. Now let's look closely. The total of this invoice is, let me make this as high up as possible. The total of the invoice, I don't know if you can see it, is $8,027. That includes $225 of New York State tax on only the items that are taxable for New York. And it includes $282 of taxable New Jersey state tax that includes only the items that are taxable for New Jersey. So after we click Save and Close, the amount that's owed to New York State should go up by $225, and the amount that's owed to New Jersey should go up by $282. After we click Save and Close and click No for this and click Ignore all the spelling, we finally save the invoice, and now we can click Vendors, Sales Tax Liability Report. Don't forget to push A for all on your keyboard so you see all the tax you owe. Now, when we look at the New Jersey Sales Tax Department and we come all the way across and we ask, why do we owe this money to New Jersey? Well, when we double click, we can see the March 15th invoice that we just made added $282 to what we owe to New Jersey tax. And if we ask New York State tax, why do we owe $1,109 to New York State? If we double click that total, we can see that this March 15th invoice that we just did added just $225 to what we owe to New York State. So this method will work, and I hope it works well for you.